Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm Rob. So kind of halfway in the sun, halfway out of the sun. It's about 11:30 in the afternoon, morning. But I wanted to get this started, so apologies if it's kind of dark where I'm filming with the shadows and whatnot. Anyway, today's video, I'm going to be reviewing the Meatstick, was sent to me by the nice folks over at Meatstick. Four sensor wireless meat thermometer. Temps, apologies for the wind too. Great day. Let's see, the ceramic handle, which does the ambient, goes from 14 degrees to 572 degrees. And then the probe you stick in the meat goes from 14 to 212. The range has up to 650 feet, it says, and it'll last 70 plus hours on a full charge. So what we're going to do, we're going to use this. I have a small pork shoulder that I used Uncle Steve's Lucky Shake. You got to use this. You got to try it if you haven't. I have a ink bird here, which I actually just checked this morning, calibration-wise, boiling water. And then both the probes came up 212 and held. So I would say it's pretty accurate. Now the Meatstick, they say not to use the boiling water test. So you can do an ice bath test, but that's at 32 degrees. And I'm gonna be using this in things that want 250 degrees or so. So I need to see if it's accurate up at that level. So we've come up to temperature now. Let's see what we're looking at here. Let's see, the ink bird's reading about 270. I'm actually going to lower the temp a little bit here. And close the vent a tiny bit. Get that back down to about, I want to right around 250 or so. Okay, pop them right at the center. I'm going to put this exactly where the other one is. I'm gonna push it all the way in so all the probe is hidden in there. Okay, let's close it back up. All right, so now let's go ahead and set up the cook. It's super windy and cold out there. So you open the app, and so they give you a little advertisement when you open it. And then they want you to rate it. I'll say not now. So anyway, now we're looking at this screen. So I'm gonna click the, and I don't know how to share my phone screen with you on a video. So let's try it like this. All right. So I'm gonna go set up cook. Smoke. What are we doing? Pork, right? We're going to do pork butt pulled. So it wants it to be 203 when it's finished. And ambient temp at 225. I'm actually doing 250. That's good. Next. Sending the cook to Meatstick. We're almost there. I already inserted it. Shows you how to do it. I have silent mode on, that's fine. All right, you can click this and it should give us a, once it starts gathering data, it'll give us a little chart there. So right now it thinks it's 145 internal temp, or not internal, ambient, and the meat is 41. There we go, now it gave us some data. So let things settle in, get about a half hour or so, and we'll see where the Meatstick is versus the ink bird. So, hey guys, it's been about a half hour. Let's see what we're doing here. Let's see, we go to Inkbird, and we're looking at 239 for ambient temperature. Ah, and I never put the probe in, did I? 43 for the internal. So I'm gonna do that in a minute. So what was that? 239. Let's go to the Char Griller app. We're looking about 234. Let's go to the Meatstick app. That's saying 204. Internal temp is 74. So what I'm going to do now is I'll put the internal probe from the Inkbird in there and see where we look. Maybe like in another half hour once things all settle again. So as you can tell, this cook really isn't about cooking a mini pork shoulder. But it's a great experiment. Most things you're going to be cooking at around 240, 250 anyway, 225, whatever. So this is a pretty good, I think, test for the meat stick, since that's mostly what I'll be using it for. So we'll be back in a bit. So it's been about a total of 2.5 hours so far, and I noticed about 45 minutes ago that the meat stick is getting closer to the correct temp. Right now it says about 230. Internal temp about 155. The Inkbird is saying 248 and 160 for internal. So I'm going to go ahead and pull it and wrap it up. And I'm not going to go too crazy with this because it's not really a video about the pulled pork. But I'll go ahead and show you. It's looking pretty good though. Super windy. So that's not going to work because it wants to be in all the way. Plus, I just made a giant hole in here. Let's see. Let's try that. Yeah, so I just wanted to get out of the wind out there. It's cold. It's like, I mean, not crazy cold like some of you guys have, but it's probably about 34 degrees out and super windy, as you can see. So what do I think about the meat stick so far? Probably just gonna end this video out right now because we've done our we've done what we needed to do. If that was my only temperature probe for ambient temp, I would have been going crazy at the beginning of this cook because it was off about 40 degrees. What was it? It thought it was about 208 when the temp was really 250. This particular model, the 4X, is new, and it goes for about $125. And you saw it did finally catch up, but it was after a little while, probably about 2 hours, until it started to be a little bit more accurate. It was still off, right? So it said it was 230 when it was really like 245 in there. That's not that bad. So this happened to me with another cook I did when I was testing this out a week or two ago. And I emailed the company. I said, hey, I noticed that this is like 25-35% off, you know, inaccurate. Lower, you know, it's showing lower temps than what it is. They replied and said, apologize for any inconvenience you may have experienced with your meat stick. Has ambient temp resistance of up to 572 degrees. The ambient temp sensor is touching the stainless steel cap of the probe. Because of the heat diffusion, the handle and cap must come to temperature, and that's what the sensor is measuring. As the surface area is rather large and it's next to the meat, the sensor will tend to measure something a bit different than other ambient sensors, either grill or oven temperature. This is because of the humidity coming off the meat, as well as it not being an instant read measuring one point. And then goes on, if I want to test the accuracy, I could do an ice bath test. And it's a great, there's lots of great options in the app for the Meatstick. However, I need to know what the ambient temp is, like for real. And I think because it's so close to the meat, it's just the humidity or something's cooling that down, and it's not giving me an accurate reading. It could be accurate as to what the temperature is right there above the meat, but I want to know what the temperature is for the meat itself. You know, what's... So anyway, that Inkbird I was using, it's like $40 on Amazon. It has four probes, so you can get the ambient, and then also you could, you know, pop in three probes to different meats, and it comes with the four probes, so you're good to go. Anyway, for me, is this the thumbs up or thumbs down? I'd say it's a thumbs down. I mean, it was reading accurate toward the end here. Well, we're not at the end, we're at the stall at 160, but has another 40 to go. But anyway, I would have just been cranking the heat up on the grill thinking that the grill was too low. So for me, I would not purchase the Meatstick. But if you have one, let me know in the comments below what you think. Let me know what you think of this video. Thumbs up, thumbs down. And we'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.